But first, after a week of rolling protests, Premier Daniel Andrews needs to outline an opening up plan and give people something to look forward to. Victoria is set to become the city that's been in lockdown more than any other place in the world. Remember when Daniel Andrews said Melbourne was going into a short, sharp lockdown, unlike New South Wales?
You only get one chance to go hard and go fast. If you wait, if you hesitate, if you doubt, then you'll always be looking back wishing you had done more earlier. I am not prepared to avoid a five-day lockdown now only to find ourselves in a five-week or a five-month lockdown. That's why we're making this very difficult decision.
Well, that was more than 2 months ago, and people are now becoming fed up. Yet despite the clear uprising, you have premiers refusing to lift restrictions, even when vaccination rates hit that 80% figure. None of us want to live in a community with COVID, but we can't stay in lockdown forever. Businesses can't survive, families can't survive, it's just not possible. And yet, even with these lockdowns, Melbourne's case numbers are continuing to rise, and they're almost, well, they're becoming almost as close as Sydney's. 779 cases in Victoria today, compared to 961 in New South Wales. Daniel Andrews attributes this to lockdown fatigue.
I think fatigue in our community is a very real thing. I'm not excusing bad behaviour, but I'm trying to explain it. That's why it's so hard, but so important that we just see this thing through.
And the Queensland Premier Annastacia Palaszczuk has no desire to open up either her state or international borders anytime soon, irrespective of the vaccination rate.
Well, where are you going to go? Are you going to go to India? In Tokyo, you have to sit in Perspex screens with masks on, and if you remove your mask, you can't talk while you're eating. Yes, in Europe, some people are travelling. I think the federal government needs to identify very clearly what are the countries that Australians can travel to.
We are seeing no clear direction here from the premiers at all. Queensland and WA are intent on keeping out COVID, but what is the foreseeable future look like? What does the plan look like? There is no long-term vision here. And it's all very well for our politicians who make these rules because they're jet-setting around the world themselves. There have been dozens of overseas trips taken so far by the likes of Scott Morrison, Dan Tehan, Maurice Payne, Peter Dutton, even Annastacia Palaszczuk herself. Government business and Australia's national security is very important. But so are private businesses. So are the lives of every person in this country. Yet they are banned from travelling for work or to see family, and Australians living overseas still haven't been able to make it home. And this is part of the reason why we're starting to see those rolling protests in Melbourne, that uprising. Even the pictures on Sydney on the weekend of people, they've just had enough of the lockdown. They're getting out and about, living their lives as normal. Everyone has had enough of the lockdowns and enough of the hypocrisy.
Once you get to 80% of your population that's vaccinated, well, it's very clear. I can't see any reason why Australians should be kept from each other. And so that puts a heavy responsibility on those who would seek to prevent that from happening.
That was Scott Morrison just this morning. And those protesting the laws in Melbourne this week were dealt with by rubber bullets, tear gas, and violence. They were ugly scenes by every measure. Ugly violence from the police and despicable actions from the protesters were those who chose to desecrate the Shrine of Remembrance. You look at Australia right now, and it's a mess. And you have to ask, where does this all end?